Hey everybody, this is Jeremy from Blockchain WTF, and I'm here to bring you the latest edition of Business on the Blockchain. Today we're covering a permission ledger that's being put forth by JP Morgan, Quorum. So what exactly is Quorum? Quorum calls itself an enterprise-focused Ethereum. In fact, the vast majority of the code is the same. However, it is an application used to process private transactions specifically for a permission group of known participants. Quorum uses smart contracts to create an ecosystem that allows for the Quorum private blockchain to function. Like most blockchains, their goal is scalability, and for this project, it comes in the form of processing enough transactions so that Quorum can be a functional payment system. We've seen what happens when the Ethereum network gets too clogged. The transparency and decentralized processing offered by the EVM, Ethereum Virtual Machine, makes the public chain currently unviable for a large amount of transactions. Quorum has focused on four specific goals they want their blockchain to accomplish, and you can see how they are pretty different from the original Ethereum blockchain. The biggest difference, Quorum is permissioned, so will not be open and transparent to everybody. While public blockchains have a certain level of anonymity, the users of Quorum are two or more pre-identified parties. This ecosystem makes it significantly easier for businesses to interact while mitigating the friction that has previously restricted their activities or charged them extra. Another main difference between the Ethereum chain and Quorum is privacy. While the parties using the Ethereum blockchain may be unidentified, the data that is transmitted to the blockchain is transparent and viewable by anyone. This might not be ideal for businesses as they might not want all of their valuable data out there and open for anybody to use or see. Quorum's permission blockchain has an answer for this. Since the parties are public, the information does not have to be. This allows businesses to exchange sensitive data without worrying about the issue of data escape. Data escape is actually a pretty simple concept. Let's just say that you have some data that's valuable. You want to monetize it somehow. You can sell your data set, but once you do, your data can be resold and just out there for anyone to use on the open market. This is an issue that enterprise is very aware of, and these companies are turning to Quorum to solve the problem of data escape. We've already discussed some issues with the Ethereum blockchain, like transaction processing and what they're facing, and most of them have to do with scaling the network. But what really determines the speed of a network? Short answer, reaching consensus. The harder it is to reach consensus, the longer confirmation will take. Because Quorum is closed in permission, it is easier to reach consensus, allowing Quorum to process hundreds of transactions per second compared with Ethereum's current 15 to 20 transactions per second. Quorum uses a simple majority voting mechanism for validation. Pre-selected delegates are given voting privileges. And while this might not be the ideal way to reach consensus in an open blockchain, this gives more control to the parties looking to execute a transaction on Quorum. JP Morgan is the organization behind Quorum, and it's likely the software will be deployed for use in the banking and financial sector. However, as Quorum grows and develops, JP Morgan sees more varied uses for Quorum on the horizon. And that's how Quorum is priming itself to be a key player in business on the blockchain. If you have any questions or comments on Quorum, throw those down below in the comment section. Also, be sure to leave us a like and subscribe so you don't miss out on any future business on the blockchains. And if you have any more cryptocurrency or blockchain questions, be sure to head over to blockchain.wtf. Chances are we have a video about your question. This has been Jeremy with Blockchain WTF. I'll see you next time.